on, yo, what is up, what is up, what is up, yeah, you guys see what I got in my H-A-N-D, I know you guys are saying, damn, Straighter Reviews, you're bringing a review to your channel because the channel has been lacking my review, so I may be a little bit of rusty, just to be real with you guys out there, but I thank you guys for at least coming to my channel to check it out as well, because I'm going to be doing more to the channel. I'm loving Black Ops 4, because for the simple fact is that we all know that Treyarch brings the best Call of Duties of all time to the gaming console. First it was Infinity Ward, but they just, you know, fell off the map. I'm gonna tell you guys, they fell off the map, you know what I'm saying, because all they have is the classic under their belts, Call of Duty 4, and also Modern Warfare 2, and then when they, you know, released Ghost, they started falling off the, you know, Richter scale, because I believe Ghost was a game into with Sledgehammer as well. 2 years ago, they released Infinity War, you know what I'm saying, Warfare, whatever the heck it's called, the space game, which I did love. Not too many people love that game because, you know, of the space aspects and all that. Then next year, when Call of Duty come around, we have Infinity War again. Yeah, so when they announced this game, everybody was, you know, hyped and happy about it, because for the simple fact is that we have this battle royale going on right now, you know, starting from, you know, player battle, you know, unknown. Black Ops got announced with blackout mode. Everybody was all pumped, talking about, oh my gosh, this is going to be a very, very well quality made player battle PUBG, however you call it, game that is finally coming to the table. Now, blackout mode is a battle royale. It's got the map featuring, you know, old school maps, you know, put into a whole entire big landscape, and you get to land just like any other type of, you know, battle royale games, with the parachutes, with the, you know, paragliders, whatever you have in Call of Duty as well. That is a great addition. Now, I felt that the whole entire map was too, it was kind of small. It wasn't much big and expanded like you have in PUBG. Hopefully, later on down the line, as the, you know, patches come, they will add new elements into it, expand the map a little bit, add more, you know, regions and more lands and islands as well. It does have, you know, sections in there of the Firing Range, Nuketown Island, all sorts of great stuff. And also, I was looking for like a, you know, it would have been cool if they would have added like a, you know, a snow place in there as well, you know, where you can actually fly to, you know, have like a different type of weather element. But what I felt that was missing in the game is cosmetics, you know what I'm saying? We all know that's just starting up. What I mean by cosmetics is I felt that the game was just thrown in there really fast, you know, just to get our approach to, you know, rush to it, which we did flock to. And what I mean by changing our clothes is bring in a third person perspective view. Now, we all know that Call of Duty is, you know, known for its first person, you know, aspects of, you know, you can just see the hands and the guns. But if they want to make this a true more experience to a blackout, you know, with the battle royale, they need to bring a third person view up in there where we can see the whole character as well, and then that will actually tackle everything that, you know, that's for the loving. It's easier to play, and it's basically kind of fair, because, you know, you got energy bars, and also you got perks, you know, added on, you know, that you can actually get, that you can actually pick up. I felt that when you land, it needed to be more, you know, weapons to be able to have access to, because I felt that, you know, when you land, you know, some places are just bare bones and you can't find a weapon and you end up getting killed. Another thing too is that it doesn't even have a tilt like, you know, PUBG, and hopefully they add it in there. What I felt in the game, which was the body armor, was too much overpowered, because for the simple fact is that it was like a too much chore shooting at a super soldier, shooting at a Terminator type of character, and it was very well frustrating, because for the simple fact is that it just makes you just lose the momentum of trying to get your kill on blackout mode as well. So hopefully, like, you know, over the time, they will add these elements in here that we want. So you got to have a headset to bring in team work in this game, because I always told myself, I said, if the makers of Call of Duty get into the battle of this battle royale and make their own PUBG like game, the original PUBG game is not over, it's still there, but from the aspect, it's a PUBG type of game where we all should have got from the beginning. I felt that, yes, it's the idea of throwing, you know, old school type of maps on the whole land. I think that they should have just started from the ground up and put whole new areas of new maps just for the blackout mode. And then later on, come with another full set of maps introducing the old school, you know, type of maps in a whole, you know, type of setting as well. But I love it though, y'all. Don't get me wrong, y'all. With the blackout mode, with this? Are they going to actually support it for years and years and years down the line? Because for the simple fact is that I was saying to myself, I said, so what is going to actually happen next year when a new Call of Duty come out? Are they going to just continue to sway away to another Battle Royale Call of Duty mode? Are they going to continue to work on this Blackout mode in Black Ops 4? You know, like, and, you know, as well as they working on the new Call of Duty as well? Because for the simple fact is that we all know that these Call of Duty games basically expire each and every year with their, you know, image, you know, because for some of that, that's how it goes. The multiplayer into Black Ops 4 is back at it again with that old school style that everybody loves, that is basically boots on the ground, you know what I'm saying? Because Black Ops 3, nobody really liked it, you know, starting from Advanced Warfare, Black Ops 3, with all the jumping around crap going on, the jetpacks was really irritating people. So in this one, they actually listen to the fans out there. And what I say about the Black Ops 4, y'all, Black Ops 4 is what Black Ops 3 should have been. It brings old school, you know, specialists, which is Prophet, Ruin, which is Prophet is my favorite, you know, character of all time, you know, with his electricity stuff, and also Battery, which is, I believe it's the female, and it has a bunch of other old school Prophet characters as well. I felt that they should have left them out and put whole brand new specialists. The reason why they brought them into the, you know, into Black Ops 4 is because for the simple fact is that here, is because these are characters that people can't forget. These are characters that people actually love in Black Ops 3. So they say, hey, let's carry it over and let's bring, you know, some maps in there, some old school modern touches with the maps as well. They got a lot of old school maps in there. They got too many old school maps. Every time these guys release a new map pack, they always bring, you know, remakeable old school maps. And that's probably what they're not doing this time around. They're probably just going to just bring us all new maps into the multiplayer as well. All know that Call of Duty has the same run and gun aspect, you know, patchy here and there, you know what I'm saying, that everybody's, you know, accustomed to, you know, talking mess and talking crap, but we is also going to play it. I felt that the range with the mostly guns, it lacked, you know, the guns, you know, for a more very better variety, because for simple fact that we all know that later on they're gonna come with more new guns. So basically I felt that the game also was just throwing out there with, you know, bare bones, but more gonna be added onto it as well. But this right here brings it to you, and you really is going to love Black Ops 4. You already know that they kept the campaign out of it. These companies are just following the bandwagon and trying to make money, trying to make a quick sale. And I felt that the developers lied about it because it was, you know, they had time, because for simple fact is that they released the game in October, and you know, these games mostly come out in November, and I'm pretty sure that they had enough more time to make a campaign. Who's to say? They may make it later on down the line as a free downloadable add-on update. But we also have Specialist HQ, which is, it has a backstory chronicle lies with Black Ops 3, I believe, and Black Ops 2 and 1, I believe, if I'm right or wrong, y'all. But it also makes up for that. But I felt that if they, you know, wasn't going to put a campaign into it, this game should have been at least $49, $39. You only get the multiplayer, you get the zombies, and also you get the blackout mode as well. But I also felt that it wasn't much needed for a disc game if it didn't have the campaign, a full game. But I believe the reason why they came out with a disc-based version game is because for the simple fact is that, you know, people like to have Call of Duty in their whole entire collection as well. And like I said, y'all, thank you for checking out my review. I love this game. Make sure you guys go pick it up. I'm going to be doing more game reviews as well. Y'all guys, love y'all. Straight to reviews, baby.